Welcome back to the channel, guys. We are back again for another edition of WTF Did I Just Blind Buy? And today I'm going to be talking about Shihan by Piotr Czarnecki. So stay tuned for that. And if you like the content, guys, hit that like and subscribe button. I really do appreciate it. Now, first thing I'm going to say is what I should say every video is that you shouldn't blind buy, and this today is going to be a good representation of that. So I will spoil the fun and tell you up front, this is not a fragrance that I was particularly a fan of. I don't not enjoy this one. I don't think it's bad. It doesn't smell bad, but had I smelled it before buying it, I probably would never buy this bottle. This is a fragrance which I decided to buy because it always piqued my interest. Somebody actually did a scent me of it, of me at some point, and they did mention this fragrance as one that I should try out. And looking at the notes, it's definitely something that I would think that I would enjoy. Whiskey, tobacco, coffee, very good notes for my nose. I love coffee fragrances. I love boozy tobacco fragrances. I like a good tobacco fragrance. I like a good boozy fragrance. So you put them together, and to me, I felt like this was definitely going to be an absolute win. So before I actually get into what I thought of it and how it works for me and why I think what I do, I will show you the presentation. It actually is a very nice bottle, I will say. This is a nice little plaque here. This isn't just a sticker, it's actually a nice plaque. It looks like it's stained wood or something like that. Very cool cap on the beginning or at the top with a nice logo. And I actually have to say, the perfumer has a really cool story too. He's a dancer, or used to be a dancer, and he made scents individually for his clients so that they could feel in the moment when they were dancing. And that's a really cool idea, in my opinion, capturing the emotion of and the artisticness of dance and combining it with the emotion and the artisticness of perfumery. I think that's really cool. But into the fragrance, and why I don't really like it that much is that for me, I just get a very dry sort of hay-like smell on my skin, and that is all it smells like for pretty much the entire life of the fragrance. So I feel like the tobacco is maybe a little bit green, and it does give off this sort of raw hay-like vibe. I don't get any booziness. Now, as you'll notice, the bottle is quite empty. I did certainly decant some of this. So when I was decanting this, I can tell you that I could really prominently get the coffee. And actually, I got coffee more than anything else. There was a little something I could smell in the background. Couldn't quite sort of put my name or my nose on exactly what it was I was smelling, but it was a dominated coffee fragrance. And I did actually decant some of this out before spraying it on myself, before trying it out. And so I was actually very surprised that when wearing it and when smelling it, even on paper, I really don't get much of that coffee note. So it is perhaps one of these cases where it smells different in the air around me and I personally don't smell it. And that's fine. I mean, if it does smell boozy and tobacco-y in the air, that's really cool. But again, for me anyways, I wear fragrances because they're things I enjoy and I enjoy smelling. That's the biggest reason that I wear things. It's a great plus if other people think I'm, you know, smell good or whatever the case is, but I want to wear fragrances that I enjoy. And this one for me just did not do it. You know, it has the note composition of something that I would like, but just something about the way that it's blended, something about the way that it works, it's not as good as I had anticipated. Now, I have wondered if maybe this one has been reformulated. I don't have any guarantees or information on that. I just did, after smelling this one, trying it several times, I watched other people's videos on them, and I noticed, for example, that when they're holding up the bottle, when they're showing the color, the juice that they had is a lot darker. This is pretty clear almost. It's a little bit pink, and it does not have this really dark, rich color that some of the other fragrance did have. Now, I got this one from Lucky Scent, so I'm pretty confident that it is, in fact, the original. It is the real deal. I don't know if it was blended differently. I don't know if there's been reformulation. Maybe it's exactly the same and smells the same as before. So I don't actually have any information on that. I'm just wondering if maybe that is the case with this one. It certainly is something that happens. In either case, I would say I get more of a hay-like tobacco, very kind of a little bit of a greeny vibe. I don't get the coffee, and I absolutely don't get the whiskey. And that is just unfortunate for me. So this one didn't work for me, and this is the problem with blind buys. So now you guys can learn and not be like me. Don't blind buy things, because this is one I would not have picked up otherwise. Anyways, guys, that's it for this one. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. I'll see you guys in the next video.